Alright guys, so I was wrong. It seems like another Bitcoin crash is coming. Okay, I really do believe guys, okay, in the next potentially, you know, even the next few days, few weeks, okay, soon, okay, we're gonna see Bitcoin having another correction back down to the downside. And in this video guys, I really want to explain why I personally think, okay, and it seems like it's not just me, but a lot of, you know, other people out there that aren't fact, you know, Bitcoin investors, that are generally, you know, Bitcoin investors and just in the crypto space, they believe that Bitcoin, right, soon enough, who knows when, right, like I said, you know, in the next few days, next few weeks, is going to have another correction back down to the downside. So in this video, okay, I'm looking at the Bitcoin chart. And Bitcoin right now is sort of, you know, forming, okay, sort of following the same pattern, okay, as what it did back in 2019 to 2020, right? And in this video, I will obviously, you know, show you guys what I mean and why I believe we're gonna see Bitcoin having a pretty decent, you know, correction back down to the downside, okay? And don't think, okay, that this is something bad for Bitcoin or anything like that. Take this as an opportunity to buy more Bitcoin. I know a lot of you guys watching this video right now missed the opportunity on buying Bitcoin back in, let's just say, 2022, right? Or even just last year, 2023. Okay, if you missed buying Bitcoin in 2022 to 2023, just last year, this is literally your once in a lifetime opportunity right now, okay, to buy as much Bitcoin as you possibly can, okay, at a cheap price, right? And I get it guys, you know, when you're simply just, you know, DCAing into Bitcoin, we don't care what the price is for Bitcoin, right? Like, you shouldn't care. There's not a huge difference buying Bitcoin where it is at right now, you know, $42,000 versus if it goes back down to $35,000. You know, that's not like a massive difference, right? But let's just say Bitcoin does drop back down to, you know, that level of $35,000, you know, you should obviously take that as an opportunity to buy more Bitcoin, right? Because that is obviously a huge drop, right? So let's talk about it guys. Okay, I really do believe, okay, that Bitcoin is going to have a crash is coming for Bitcoin. Okay, it really is guys. Okay, there's huge potential here that we're gonna see Bitcoin having a crash very soon, you know, like I said, in the next few days or potentially in the next few weeks. And the reason why guys I'm saying I was wrong is because, right, if you guys have in fact been watching my videos, I've been telling you guys that, you know, it's all up from here. Okay, I don't know if you guys remember, but a couple of weeks ago, you know, Bitcoin made history, right? Obviously we know something very bullish just happened a couple of weeks ago for Bitcoin. Bitcoin ETFs were officially approved. Okay, so that was massive. Okay, a lot of institutions, okay, filed for Bitcoin spot ETFs and they were officially approved by the SEC. Okay, so that's obviously huge news. And we would expect Bitcoin to skyrocket. And I told you guys that, you know, 50K Bitcoin is coming, right? And as I'm filming this video, Bitcoin's currently holding just above $42,000. So yes, it's not too far away from, you know, reaching 50K. But I'm gonna show you guys the chart, right? The Bitcoin chart and why I believe we're gonna see another correction back down to the downside for Bitcoin. Really soon, actually, right, next few days, few weeks potentially, we will see. But soon enough, we're gonna see Bitcoin having a correction. That's just personally my opinion, and like I said, a lot of people out there aren't fact saying that we're gonna see, you know, a crash coming for Bitcoin, and I totally get where they're coming from, right? But yeah, I was wrong guys. Okay, you know, 50K Bitcoin, it doesn't seem like it's gonna happen potentially after the halving. Okay, so April after the halving, yes, we will potentially see a 50K Bitcoin. Like, I do see Bitcoin having another correction, okay, this last correction, and then it's just gonna shoot up from there, right? It's not gonna be all ups from here, okay? But, you know, after the halving, we're gonna see Bitcoin having some massive pumps, because we know every single time we have the Bitcoin halving, this is when Bitcoin tends to pump the most, and this is when the real bull run begins for Bitcoin. And we know what that means, right, for the entire crypto market. Right, alt season, okay, altcoins are gonna absolutely skyrocket as well. It's not just gonna be Bitcoin, so be prepared for that, you guys. Right, so yeah, I was wrong, okay? We're not gonna see a 50K Bitcoin anytime soon, seems like. And we're gonna, you know, see Bitcoin having a correction back down to the downside. So let me show you guys the Bitcoin chart. Okay, so let me show you guys what I mean. So I got it here. Okay, this is Bitcoin. You guys can clearly see like coin market cap. I feel like it's more easier to show you guys on this. It's like more simple than on TradingView. But you guys can clearly see, okay, this is what I mean. So back in 2017, okay, we saw Bitcoin shoot up all the way up to around $19,000, almost 20K. You guys can just clearly see that, right? And that was great times, okay, because that was actually the first time we've seen Bitcoin reach over 10K, okay, and almost up to 20K, okay. A lot of people did obviously FOMO into Bitcoin at that time. And I felt like that year in 2017, a lot of people got into Bitcoin and started talking more about Bitcoin, obviously, right? And then, of course, 2018, that's when we entered another bear market, and that's when we saw Bitcoin having a drop, right? So it went all the way up from $19,000 all the way back down to about $3,300. Okay, so from $19,000 all the way back down to $3,300. Okay, so keep that in mind, that guys, like that is a huge drop, right? So after that, right, that was 2018. That entire year, it was just all downs from there, okay, downhill from there. You guys can clearly see that. But then 2019 arrived and we saw Bitcoin slowly recovering up to the upside. It went all the way up to around 12K, right? You guys can clearly see that, right? $11,900 in 2019, right? In 2019, it was sort of, you know, dropping. You guys can clearly see that. And then it had a huge drop right here in 2020, okay? Early of 2020, we saw Bitcoin having a pretty decent drop all the way back down to $5,000, okay? And you guys can see after that drop, okay, after that correction, we did in fact see Bitcoin having a massive pump up to the upside. And I understand, guys, in 2020, that was the year when we had our halving event for Bitcoin, okay? And that's when we entered the next bull run for Bitcoin, right? We saw what happened in 2021. Bitcoin was absolutely shooting up to the upside. So the same exact thing is happening right now for Bitcoin. Let me explain, okay? So we saw 2021. Bitcoin was absolutely skyrocketing. And then what happened in 2022, we saw Bitcoin having a massive drop back down to the downside. You guys can just clearly see that, right? It was all downhill from there, right? We remember what happened in 2022. Bad times. Honestly, one of the worst bear markets ever, in my personal opinion, right? A lot of, you know, crypto exchanges has gone bankrupt and shut it down. We saw what happened with, for example, Terra Luna, and that obviously caused the entire crypto market to collapse. And we were already in a bear market, guys. So it just got even worse and worse and worse. So in my personal opinion, literally one of the worst bear markets ever. One of the worst, okay? But yeah, we survived it. So yeah, that's 2022, okay? It dropped all the way down. And then we know what happened in 2023, just last year. We saw Bitcoin absolutely, you know, pumping up to the upside slowly, gaining back its momentum and recovering up to the upside. You guys can just clearly see, and this is where we are right now, at $42,100. Okay, so that's what happened with Bitcoin. Let me explain again. 2017, okay, it pumped. 2018, it dropped. And then 2019, it slowly pumped again, slowly recovering, just like what Bitcoin is doing right now. And then 2020, what happened in 2020, right? The Bitcoin halving event year, okay, it dumped, right? It had a small correction, okay, and then it slowly pumped. And then it just went all ups from there. And guess what, guys? 2024 right now, this is in fact the halving event year, okay? And what we are in fact seeing right now for Bitcoin, okay, is that yes, it is in fact pumping, but I understand it's going to have another correction, just like what it did right here, guys, right here, okay, right there, just like what it did in early of 2020. It had a small correction and then it went back up a little bit, and then it just absolutely exploded. So I understand, guys, yes, we're gonna see potentially another small correction back down for Bitcoin. Understand, guys, Bitcoin likes to repeat the same patterns, okay? I really want you guys to understand that, right? Bitcoin, okay, over the like years or so, it likes to repeat the same patterns. You know, it sort of rhymes, guys, right? It's always a 4-year cycle, okay? And the reason why I always say it's a 4-year cycle is because we know pretty much every 4 years a Bitcoin halving event happens, and then we enter you know, a bear market and we enter a bull market. So pretty much they say it's 3 good years and 1 bad year, right? So understand, guys, this chart that Bitcoin is forming right now, it's sort of similar to where it was back in 2019 and 2020. It just looks very, very similar. So yes, you know, 2020, just like what I showed you guys, Bitcoin had a small correction. Okay, it was at around $9,000, and then it dropped all the way back down to $5,000. Then from there on, it slowly went back up, and then it just absolutely skyrocketed. So it seems like, right, it's gonna do the exact same thing. Okay, that's why, guys, I believe, okay, a crash is coming for Bitcoin, right? And I feel like a lot of people are in fact putting long positions, so a lot of people are going to be liquidated, okay? A lot of people are going to lose money, okay, potentially, right? So that's that. That's just my personal opinion, guys. You guys let me know in the comments below what you guys think, okay? But that is just my personal opinion of why I truly do believe, you know, soon enough, you know, in the next few days, next few weeks, we're going to see Bitcoin having a drop, okay, having another correction back down to the downside. And who knows where it's going to be heading. Could be, you know, to $37,000, $35,000, $32,000. Okay, I don't see Bitcoin going lower than 30K. It could, okay. Seems like nothing is impossible nowadays. It's possible. So we will see, guys. No one actually knows, but understand a crash is coming for Bitcoin, okay? So be prepared for that and don't panic. Like I told you guys at the beginning of this video, take this as an opportunity, okay? Take this as an opportunity to buy more Bitcoin, okay? Stack more Satoshis, guys, okay? This is literally a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to buy as much Bitcoin as you possibly can while it's still below 100K, while it's still below 50K, right? This is a great time right now to buy Bitcoin, not financial advice. Always do your own research, guys. So that's that, guys. I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. Give thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you guys have not yet already. That is always appreciated. More videos will, in fact, be coming your way. So stay tuned for that. And I'm going to catch you guys all in my next video. Have a good one, guys.